مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى من الرحمن يهدينا به للصالحات وللمكارم والتقى هذا كتاب الله أعذب منهل
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome to the second part of our series where we will be inshallah covering the explanation of the text of 40 hadith pertaining to the virtues and the rulings of the Quran. In this reminder inshallah we'll be looking at the hadith of Aisha radiallahu anha where she reported that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said مثل الذي يقرأ القرآن وهو حافظ له مع سفرة الكرام البررة, that the example of the one who recites the Quran and he is someone who has memorized it, then he will be with the righteous noble scribes, i.e. the angels. ومثل الذي يقرأ القرآن, and the example of the one who recites the Quran, وهو يتعاهده, and he strives to recite the Quran and he exerts a lot of effort to recite the Quran, وهو عليه شديد, but it is difficult upon him to recite the Quran and he finds it very difficult, فله أجران, then for him he will have two rewards. This is a very well-known hadith that speaks about the virtues of those who read the Quran and they are proficient in its recitation and they have memorized the Quran. So مثل الذي يقرأ القرآن, the example of the one who recites the Quran, meaning the one who continuously recites the Quran in every moment of the time, then the opportunity they have to recite the Quran, they recite it, they ponder and reflect over its meanings. وَهُوَ حَافِظٌ لَهُ, and he is someone who has memorized it. And according to another version of the hadith, it mentions the word, and he is ماهر, meaning he is a proficient and expert reciter. Then such a person, what is his virtue? Then he will be with the safara, the noble scribes, the angels. And the scribes, the angels, they are those who pass on the revelation to mankind. These are the angels that pass on the revelation to mankind. And hence they were given this description as being the safara, the scribes who write down the revelation. And so the hafidh of Quran, the one who memorized the Quran and knows the Quran very well, then he is just like these angels. And hence he's been likened to them. And also they are kiram, they are honorable in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are barara, they are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the one who recites the Quran, and he has to exert a lot of effort in it, because he is not a proficient reciter of the Quran. And it is shadeed upon him, and it is difficult upon him to recite. Then for him, and another version it says, وَهُوَ عَلَيْهِ شَاقٌ, and it is difficult for him to recite, فَلَهُ أَجْرَانٌ, then he will have two rewards. Many people unfortunately though misunderstand this hadith, and they think that it means that the one who struggles to recite the Quran actually gets double the reward of the proficient reciter. But this is not the case, as the scholars have mentioned. Rather, the proficient reciter gets much more reward than the one who struggles to recite the Quran. So what does it mean that he will have two rewards? Meaning he will have one reward for reading the Quran and he will have another reward for going through the hardship of reciting the Quran. But without a shadow of a doubt, the hafidh of the Quran, the proficient reciter of the Quran, he will have much more reward, and he will be with those angels. He's on the same station as those angels in paradise, as many scholars said, because he resembles the angels, because they preserved the Quran and they passed on the Quran to mankind. Likewise, the hafidh of the Quran, the one who memorized the Quran and has learnt it, then he will be with such people. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from the people of the Quran. And inshallah ta'ala, in the next reminder, we will be looking at the hadith of Anas radiallahu an, where he mentions that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that the people of the Quran, they are the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are the select group of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah, tune in for that reminder inshallah ta'ala, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the people of the Quran who are the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. بارك الله فيكم والسلام عليكم
ورحمة الله. مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى من الرحمن يهدينا به للصالحات وللمكارم والتقى، نور على مر الزمان تألق.